So I don't know if you guys saw it, Stan had a live feed where he was, they were going to give away initially 5 of these static phase converters, and what the goal was you had to, while you were there watching the show, the live feed that Stan had, you had to take a picture of... Take a picture of your motor plate and your machine and send it to Chris from American Rotary. And they wanted to make sure that people that were winning these things were people that were going to use them. So I'm not going to lie, I kind of cheated. I had a phone, I had a picture in my phone already of my motor plate. So I was able to get it emailed really quickly. So pretty awesome. Okay guys, well here it is. You know, I had a bunch of stuff recorded of me installing it and running the wires and stuff like that, but it's all simple stuff. We start over here behind the welder with a NEMA 650P plug and then 10 gauge to the American Rotary static phase converter, and it's just L1 and L2 in for the single phase in, and then for this 3 phase out we go T1, T2, and T3 and another 10 gauge wire to a NEMA L 14 plug and receptacle, and that's a twist lock into the Allen Bradley motor starter, and then 14 gauge up to the drum switch. Everything from the plug up was originally on this machine. It did have a breakout for single phase 120 for running the DRO and the lamps, but I just barfed all that out. So we'll go ahead and give it a try. Well, there it is, guys, a Canadian mill running on American Rotary static phase converted power. When I purchased this machine, I wasn't really aware of how I was gonna provide 3-phase power to it. And I was familiar with rotary phase converters and I had access to a couple, but from what I remember, my experiences with them as a kid was they were kind of noisy and not something I really wanted to deal with here in the home garage. So I was kind of leaning more towards a VFD, and I wasn't aware that static phase converters existed. So I did a little bit of research once I saw Stan's post that he was going to be doing a giveaway, and figured it'd be a good opportunity for me to try one out. I purchased this mill about 6 months ago, and I got it from a shop that did machine restorations, and they did some really great work. I don't know if they were initially intending to do a restoration on this machine as well, but he needed the space. He had a lot of machinery and some really nice bridge ports and just awesome stuff. This is actually the second mill that I've owned in my life. The first mill I got was given to me when I was in high school, and me and my dad went and picked it up and hauled it to my grandfather's shop where we could unload it with forklift. And the next thing I knew was it was sold. So here it is 16 years later, and I finally have a milling machine of my own again. And it's a pretty exciting times. So I'd like to cut some for you guys, but my mill vise is in extremely rough shape. And we'll get that cleaned up and mounted up here on the table. So with that, thanks for watching, and much quieter when it's not in back gear. Well, there it is.